And notice, continue with, keep your notes, we'll have some further discussions and form up some position papers or something for tomorrow to take home to our reservations, okay? So, thank you. Trina Monil. Uranium is a very, 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 you see what's happening in North Korea right now. They're threatening the United States with uranium, nuclear weapons. And this uranium mining is being proposed in our region here again in Apesapa. And they've had some public hearings here recently. And we need to keep an update on this because we need to get tribal council backing on opposing the mining of uranium on our lands, okay?
Good evening, everybody. My name is Trina Lorto, and my Lakota name is Akichi Shapiwing, which is roughly translated as the Encourager on. I greet you all this evening with a warm heart handshake. I come here today in the capacity of my office, which is the Tribal Historic Preservation Officer for the Oglala Sioux Tribe. And I've been in the position since March 2016. And within that, the past year, I have gained a ton of knowledge. I've experienced so much within this past year. I'm a completely different person now compared to last year. But when I first came into office, the Dewey Burdock uranium mine, which lies within our sacred Black Hills, that was one of the big priority, one of the big picture issues that came across my desk and through my emails. The Oglala Sioux Tribe has been fighting since, I believe, 2009 on this issue, along with the Crow Wheat Mine, which is 40 miles south of our borders in Nebraska. And it actually lies within our original agency near Fort Robinson. So these mines, we've actually been fighting since then. In December 2016, a decision was handed down which we won two small contentions as a tribe based upon our cultural resources and based upon the NRC's lack of Section 106 consultation. So those, you know, through our little Tribal Historic Preservation Office, we won these contentions and we're keeping, I guess, basically the whole Oceti Sakowin in this game against uranium mining within our Black Hills. The mine, the Dewey Burdock mine that I'm working with in particular, this is actually, we're in federal litigation now with it. We filed in February of 2017 a federal case against NRC, the Nuclear Regulatory Commission. So we've actually, we filed in federal court. We are still in litigation with them. In the meantime, I've been offered through PowerTech, the company behind the uranium mining in Dewey Burdock. They've offered a $10,000 honorarium. They've offered to pay our monitoring staff full price for their services. And they've given me 2 weeks at their discretion. So they'll tell me when I can go out and do the monitoring and surveying of this land. But I've actually opposed that. Through the tribe, we've legally opposed these offers, and that's the only offer they've ever issued. And this was as far back as December. And we continue to say no. I say their offer is not enough to go out and desecrate our sacred lands. But I want to just read you a quick, brief update here on the cases anyways. There are currently two moving parts in the Dewey Burdock matter. One involving the administrative case still pending before the Atomic Safety Licensing Board, ASLB, and one involving the federal court proceeding pending before the U.S. Court of Appeals and the D.C. Circuit Court. Regarding the ASLB proceeding, the NRC staff recently announced that it has abandoned its NHPA Section 106 consultation and NEPA environmental review efforts, asserting that NRC staff and the Oglala Sioux Tribe were unlikely to reach an agreement on a survey approach. As is typical of this agency, They attempt to blame the child for the impasse, yet fail to fully explain the reasons they could not negotiate an acceptable survey approach to the tribe. Coinciding with the abandonment of the NHPA and NEPA efforts, NRC staff has filed a motion for summary disposition along with a statement of material facts with the ASLD, attempting to convince the board that it should go in favor of NRC staff and PowerTech on all remaining issues in the administrative case. The tribe's deadline for filing a response is September 1st, 2017. The tribe's legal counsel intend to fight the motion vigorously, as the motion relies on a severely distorted version of the facts and misstatements and misconstrues the applicable law. Regarding the federal trade case in the U.S. Court of Appeals in the D.C. Circuit, the next step is NRC's deadline for filing a response to the open brief of the tribe filed in June 2017. The NRC's response is scheduled to be filed on August 10th. 2017, PowerTech is allowed to file a response as well after the NRC files, and PowerTech's deadline is August 30th, 2017. The tribe has then an opportunity to submit a reply to their brief rebutting arguments from NRC and PowerTech. That reply is due to be filed on September 21st, 2017. And that's pretty much the updates I have on that particular one. ProView, that we've also won on the same contention. Lack of Section 106 consultation and the lack of cultural resource inventory and survey. So I'm actually working with, I'm hoping to get in contact with our all of our council is pro bono on these cases. So I have council on ProView, which is Andy Reed, and for the Dewey Burdock, which is Jeffrey Parsons and Travis Stills. But we're in contact at least twice a week. So we're very up to date on the case. Very the offer that they had offered us initially. I found that very insulting. And when I did meet, I've only talked with NRC twice this year. Once in January, and then again, I responded in May through a letter. But I haven't had much interaction verbally with them. They refused to have any more. They consider our conference calls official consultation. And so when we're on any kind of conference call like that, I make sure and say this is not official government-to-government consultation, nor is it the NHPA, the Section 106 consultation. It's just a call with updates. So, but I just wanted to keep it brief there. If you have any questions, I do have the documents. If anyone would like them, I can even email them to you, but you could just check with me on the site and your address, and I can send you those documents. But any questions? Okay, and there is actually a transcript that you can, it's actually www.ep.gov /UIC/Dewey, D-E-W-E-Y dash Burdock, U-R-D-O-C dash public dash hearings dash transcripts. And actually, they had conducted the public comment hearings all summer, and the tribe, Oglala tribe, actually issued a very large document with our official public comments on their issuance of the draft permits. And my department, which is the Historic Preservation Office, and the Water Resources Department, Natural Resources, Environmental Protection Agency, we all, with the tribal, the tribal programs, we all combined and we issued our statements together in a lot of supporting documents with that. Because this is, this is one of the issues that I think our tribal council really needs to think about. It affects all of us. It doesn't affect just the tribe. It affects every single person within our territories. And, like Bruce has stated earlier, the mismanagement and micromanagement of these funds. We really need to think of these bigger picture issues. And instead of, day-to-day emergency crisis, we need to think of these bigger pictures. pictures, because down the road, you know, I always use this analogy because I grew up, I went to high school in New Hampshire, and I witnessed the people who were born after the Three Mile Island disaster. That was a whole disaster that, you know, these people's chromosomes, their DNA was severely damaged. And I've seen the people and their effects, you know, that, you know, one day we're gonna have children born on our reservations with one eye, one little hole for a nose, and one little hole for a mouth. I mean, these are very likely to happen, you know, within the next few generations, you know, because of this contamination. And, you know, I keep thinking about, you know, last fall they let the, you know, the public, you know, public announcement about Angostura being high, you know, containing high levels of, you know, radiation and all these things. But I said, think about all the other waterways that are contaminated. And they're just now realizing this. You know, they wanted to contaminate and get rid of the Indians and our people, but they're contaminating everybody. And it's just, it is not just a tribal issue. It is a, you know, it is a valid worldwide issue that we really need to think about. So with that, I just want to thank you all for listening, and thank you for staying and waiting for this small presentation. Thanks.
Thank you, Trina. Yeah, I mean, that could be uranium, the Oglala chance, hex like a weird chance on my head. Crazy words, painful, every choice I can have. Scavage has a killer of poche of the yard. The head of Akitita, Tokala, head of Omicha, come to Hadakua, Ihamala. What Chintaka, Dagani Gartish near Kushia and Inati. Mata Diva, Iyata Ignashka. The late Urania came, Yaguk talk, hate Ahita. There are Ujima Kant Dobriata, Bakochi and Ayula. Urania, Ole. Urania, who, oh, one love for you, Sakaka. Oyate Yota, Wichaka. World War II, I think the answers. Adam Barber, who? Uranium, a Hegis, Isambia, Shita. Now, let's say, yeah, Akehina, Okaka, Kat. Tale, Oyate, Jonalada, Blihitia, Yodia, Takushia, and the Toshka, Koki, Mata, Tela, Oish, Kat. The tribal council, what teaches of Oglala, which has the Yuha, Iwaho, which are for Kushet, Mohena, Oganaka of the city. Gawita, Kina, the part of the last day, yeah, in backyard. Lena Kur, Suzetta, Sapako, Wainaka, Uta, New Kids Hockey, Ogana, Alien. And a way that the night you have moved you to Ota or Kente or Yuha, there's many very different issues affecting Indian country. And this region alone here, you heard some of that today. If these minds, these words, we can put them all in one pot and come up with some legal assistance from capable lawyers to draft legislation where we can fight against the government, to stand against these things, the pipelines, the mining of uranium, and further eradication of our resources. We need to stand together on those things. I had no more you to hear that. Lay a bit to care at a common dark or the Oglala, I mean, like you see a call. Nisha, here in Yake, Omniciye, Uyutaka, Nahena, Yuake, Yuoglaka, Nahatayake, Toshke, Yuhamukalabraha, Wakituta, Oyatu Kitwakena, Toshke, Uake, Kaho, Yusuta. They have Facebook, Twitter, telephone, and like you all you have. Takun, you woke up a cup, chance of what's a cup you have. Then if you have a cup, that's that. He had it. He can't hold on. He had it. He had it. That's not his cup. And then he said, I wish that you have six times. You wear a cup. Tribal Council agenda. Please put me on the agenda. You know, I hear it before. Now it's committee. Committee, we try to have a ten hour. You talk about Oglala, and how war, Gaza, tribal council, when I use Sutta. You are here, you are Gawita here. Literally, Choko. Gawamas, unity, unity. Lay Omniciye, Unity, Heche, you have to walk it. Heche, Awachia, Omniciye, Omega. Now, we chose I unity, there's a woke in Asaka. The effort of this meeting here, the objective, to create some unity among all of us, to leave our ego at the door, leave our personal pride, leave our tribal pride at the door. Let's all come and meet as people, as common people, and leave with a common purpose to save the future generations. Organize the Haiti Aubergroup. Hekta, 1868, how important America that's for Gashua, Haiti Nazi, Naita. Organize the Isha Haiti Wugalaka system. It changes one other Uina. The Haitian Pixia called, I envision our grandfathers deciding that 1868 treaty, the thoughts, the prayers, the troubles, the worry they had when they negotiated those treaties. Without speaking the language, without knowing the language, without writing the language, and using an interpreter that just recently learned the language themselves. How could they express all these wishes and wants and needs for us, future generations, through an interpreter who would not know how to say the right word, but still they got their message across, and that's in these treaties. And so we are still who we are. It took a lot of prayer. What we took. Guru Hava Chekya, Tata Komene, Fogashila Namkuna Oyate.